Lauren Boebert is a habitual liar and a career criminal who married a sex offender, and the two of them poisoned several dozen people. And none of those are the worst things about her. I'll explain. First, the backstory that would make Roadkill look like a Rhodes Scholar. Lauren Boebert and her sex offender husband Jason own Shooters. That's a bar and restaurant in the aptly named Colorado town of Rifle, and they encourage their employees to openly carry firearms. Now, this next part is as unbelievable as most of the things that she says. Soon after the Boeberts opened their restaurant, a man who was in a fight in another part of Rifle wandered over to down the block from Shooters and died of a meth overdose. So Lauren told everyone the man had been beat to death by another man's hands, and that it happened outside the restaurant. Which is partially true, in that the entire world is outside her restaurant. I'm recording this video in Pittsburgh, which is outside her restaurant. You're also watching it outside her restaurant. But it didn't matter to Boebert that the story was a complete fabrication where she profited off someone else's death, because Lauren Boebert will never miss an opportunity to take an opportunity. The Boeberts own two other restaurants as well, but they didn't have the chance to dishonestly take advantage of the death of an addict, so they are no longer part of the Boebert Diarrhea Empire. That is not an unfair shot. No pun intended. In 2017, Shooters was responsible for mass food poisoning. 80 cases! It happened when they set up a booth at the county fair without permits. After an investigation, the health department determined that the cause was unsafe food handling. How is it that their staff is expected to handle firearms when they can't even handle pork sliders? But enough about how Lauren Boebert made 80 people sick. Let's talk about how she's making the rest of us feel the same way. First, the Boebert's criminal history. Jason Boebert was arrested in 2004 at a bowling alley for showing his bowling balls to minors in front of Lauren, who was also a minor. The following month, he was arrested for domestic violence against Lauren. A few months after that, Lauren was arrested for assaulting Jason before the two got married the following year. What a pair. I mean the Boeberts, not Jason's exposed bowling balls. Imagine the vows. Do you take this man in domestic assault and sexual assault, in sickness and in more sickness, till meth overdose do you part? But like their hearts, their criminal record goes on. In 2010, Lauren was arrested for allowing her loose dogs to attack a neighbor's dog. In 2015, Lauren was arrested at a music festival while she tried to prevent cops from arresting underage drinkers. The Boeberts are very clearly interested in the underaged. Lauren failed to appear in court on those charges. Twice. In 2017, Lauren was arrested when she skipped court again, this time for careless driving and unsafe operation of a vehicle. And I want to be clear, simply having an arrest record should not disqualify you from public office. There are plenty of people with bogus arrests or with legitimate arrests who have been reformed since. But the kind of record Boebert has, that should absolutely disqualify her from claiming to be in support of police, and disqualify her from any claims about being a born-again Christian. What would Jesus do? Not serve diarrhea sliders. That's what Jesus would do. So how did a domestic abusing, sex offender supporting, court evading, habitually lying, food poisoning, career criminal get elected to Congress? Boebert started making a name for herself politically in 2019, when she joined various white supremacy groups in their opposition to Colorado's red flag laws, confronted Beto O'Rourke with a firearm during a town hall meeting, and openly backed QAnon, going as far as to say, "Everything I've heard of Q, I hope that this is real, because it only means America is getting stronger and better." And that all somehow helped her win an election. Well, everything I've heard of Lauren Boebert, I hope is not real, because it means America is getting weaker and worse. And it's not just her awful soundbites, and her tweets that read like they're written with alt-right fridge magnet poetry. Her positions and her actions since she's been elected are appalling. Lauren Boebert is what happens when there's a mishap at the knockoff Sarah Palin factory. Lauren Boebert is against sex education, immigration, pretty much any gun control, and national healthcare. And she wants to eliminate the Department of Education, which I guess makes sense since she's never gotten any use out of it. But wait, it gets worse. Before Boebert was sworn in, and just a few weeks before January 6th, she led an illegal late-night tour of the Capitol. Those tours are only available during business hours, to sitting members of Congress, and led by an official Capitol tour guide. Boebert didn't adhere to any of those protocols. She and her guests were trespassing. The morning of the Capitol riots, Boebert tweeted, "Today is 1776. She also previously tweeted, "I am the militia." And if that weren't enough, she has, well, been the militia. Boebert held campaign events alongside the Three Percenters, held rallies with the Proud Boys, and live tweeted Nancy Pelosi's location during the Capitol violence. It looks like she took a cue from Jason, because she's been exposing her insurrection. But if you think her awfulness ends at her policy and risking her colleagues' lives, you haven't been paying attention. Boebert has broken campaign finance laws multiple times, reimbursing herself for allegedly driving 39,000 miles during her campaign. That was later amended by the campaign to be much less. She didn't report Jason's $500,000 annual income for being a consultant for an energy company, which is a conflict of interest due to her position on the House Committee on Natural Resources. And she was recently investigated for her current re-election campaign, spending money on her personal expenses. Because when you don't punish someone for doing something, They keep doing it. Boebert also courts controversy, actively hurting people that she's supposed to represent. Just recently, she attended a Columbus Day celebration in Puebla. While the state of Colorado no longer recognizes Columbus Day, Boebert sure does, and is too dumb to even grasp the irony of speaking against Indigenous Peoples Day in a city named Pueblo. Let me be clear. I don't say that Lauren Boebert is dumb just because she received her GED after she launched her campaign. Plenty of smart people have been forced to drop out of high school, though she might be the only one to do so just to raise a child with the man who sexually assaulted her, only to eventually launch a diarrhea empire. The problem with Boebert is not her being a walking advertisement for Dunning-Kruger, which she is. The problem is she's a conspiracy-believing con artist who thinks that owning a gun is a personality, and she will say and do anything for power and attention, no matter who it hurts. Is there good news? Yes. Lauren Boebert could lose her next election. She won her primary by fewer than 10,000 votes, and she won the general election by 5.2%, a slimmer margin than Trump won in that district. And that district has been getting bluer and bluer. In the last four elections in that district, Republican congressional candidates went from landslide to barely eking it out. 23% to 14% to 8% to 5%. As demographics continue to shift, and the literacy rates in Colorado continue to rise, Boebert might be expelled like she was a poorly prepared pork slider at a county fair. And would I say this all directly to her? Well, I have. Earlier this year, Boebert tried to make a ridiculous point on Twitter, that former UK Prime Minister Tony Blair's opinion on Joe Biden somehow affected how he's viewed on the current world stage. I responded by pointing out that Tony Blair has been out of office for 14 years. And I may have called her a troglodytic simpleton. She misunderstood my point, thinking I just didn't know what the word former meant. To which I responded, 2007 was so long ago, your husband was still showing his dick to underage girls. She has not responded since, perhaps because her husband exposing himself to teenagers is what courted her in the first place. Of all the things that the Boeberts have exposed, the most off-putting one is actually who Lauren is as a person. And who she is a scared fearmonger, an authority-flaunting bootlicker, a lying truther, and an uneducated know-it-all. Simply put, great value Sarah Palin is a hypocrite, and the only thing that should be fired in her household is her. But what do I know? I should stick to comedy. Thank you for watching and following and subscribing on YouTube, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. If you want to see a live show, I'm probably performing near you soon. Check out my calendar and get tickets at stevehofstetter.com. And of course, join my Patreon, where you can see videos like this before anyone else. Patreon.com/stevehofstetter.